The Riot at the Moor. On Sunday night, a fight occurred near the camp of the Royal Horse Artillery from Maryhill Barracks, presently encamped on the Irvine Moor, and a number of men from Irvine who were the worse of drink, in the course of Sunday afternoon, and at night. It appears that the artillerymen were seen carrying beer from the canteen to men within the camp. Towards 10 o'clock, two of these men quarreled. This was the beginning of a general fight, and the artillerymen were ordered to clear the lines. Resistance was offered and some hard blows were struck on both sides, but the instigators of the tumult got the worst of it, and were forced out of the camp. It was found that some bad cuts had been sustained by them. One of their number was found insensible on the moor, and conveyed home about midnight in a cab. The occurrence has aroused considerable comment in the town and neighborhood, the feeling being at first strong against the soldiers, though there has since been a disposition to recognize that the civilians were at fault. It may be said that one or two of the men who received injuries were not in the company of those who originated the disturbance. Being attracted by the noise to the spot, they suddenly found themselves treated as rioters. The practice of allowing soldiers to convey beer to civilians is greatly condemned. The men injured are James Harrison, Minor, Cotton Row, Irvine, cut on the head and left eye. James Mitchell, Taylor, Hill Street, cut on the left eye and nose. John Rafferty, Laborer, 26 High Street, cut on the head and nose. James Ward, Minor, Cotton Row, eye blackened and slightly skinned. Alex Cowan, 4 East Back Road, eye blackened. Scullion, Laborer, 12 Peter Street, severe scalp wound. William Smith, Laborer, Duncan's Close, High Street, unable to leave the moor, badly bruised about the body, conveyed home in a cab.